sticky claws and...
Yeah, but they defend you at all costs.
It's more because they're under the control of psychokinetic thingy mabobber overlordy
exactly.
Stuffy.
Exactly, so they defend you at all costs.
Good point, good point. Now, it does look like a reserve player will be going for Ling Bling Muta, and I'm, or, you know, teching up the Ultralisk, because I'm thinking that because of the plus one ground attacks and plus one ground carapace, and whenever I start stuttering badly, the Zerg player is always thinking of something great and fun to do involving either Mutalisks or Ultralisks, so... I don't know.
Oh, there's a push coming.
Yep. So... Alejandro may be down 30 supply. He may be making a Dark Shrine because he's behind, but darn it, he has sentries and immortals. He's gonna win this game. And the drones come off the line, and the drones are dying horribly. I think Asylum may have over-droned a little bit because he was at 54 to 46, but now he's 44 to 46 and falling.
Wait, but... he doesn't have enough mushroom or recall.
Ooh. Yeah, he doesn't have enough energy for a recall, letting his immortal stay out in the open, not using his force fields efficiently.
He's gonna lose everything.
Yeah, he has enough for a recall, but he's not recalling out, and Alejandro losing all of his units to Slowlings and Roaches, a good flank by Asylum, but... Ah, man! Alejandro, what are you doing? What? This is why he couldn't cross the border, he just wasn't using his head. He didn't mass recall back when the heat came. Alejandro. Darn it.
Oh, DT.
But, you know, he is behind, so hopefully this Dark Shrine will help him out. Two DTs are going up into the natural, just waddling on. Asylum should see these, because he has ninja eyes. He can see stealth units. Hey, watch it. What? What did I say?
I don't know.
I'm not racist. I am not racist. What's wrong with you, Too Fast? You're not too pro. What's wrong with you?
Not too pro.
Mentioned a border. What border? I could be talking about the Canadian border. Because, you know, Alejandro, he could be from Canada. Trying to get into America, doesn't have a passport. What did you think I was saying? What did you think I was saying?
Sensitive, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, he didn't know I was talking about Canada. It's an honest mistake. An honest mistake.
Go watch his own
screen. I like...
I like
the Pacific border, but the ocean, in case the fishes come on, you know, the little passport.
In case of... Well, I don't like the ocean, because the Sharknadoes happen all the time, and... You've been in a Sharknado or two, right?
Not really.
You've never been in a Sharknado?
No.
You know what a Sharknado is.
I live in Wisconsin, I don't have these opportunities.
Oh, that place is entirely made of cheese, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. What kind? Or is it like varying from county to county, the kind of cheese it's made of?
It's sharp cheddar, or extreme sharp cheddar. Aged for like 15 years, really, really good.
Ooh.
If you know what I mean. Yeah.
Wait, why is it only 15 years old? Wisconsin's been a state for a bit longer than that, I do believe.
If it's any older than that, it starts to be mold.
Dude. Oh, so you eat it and then you replant it? I see. Okay, that makes sense. All right. What doesn't make sense, though, is the fact that Alejandro is making a third base as a huge attack is coming. That's a lot of roaches. What?
Which will help a little bit.
Two cannons. But his immortals and sentries and stalkers out of the way, so I think Asylum may suicide these roaches. Yeah, maybe not. That's three immortals. That's a lot of immortals. Asylum needs to focus these downs, or the immortals will kill everything he has. Focus the immortals, Asylum. Focus the immortals. Focus the. You gotta click the. You click them. And Asylum just lost his lead, okay? Asylum is now very far behind due to the fact that these immortals are actually amazing. Roaches are amazing too, but immortals are also amazing. So this spire is really what's going to put Asylum back into the game, because he needs Mutalisks. And it's 2-2? I thought it was 2-1.
2-2.
Oh, it's 2-2, because Asylum just won a game. Yeah. But, yeah, I think these Mutalisks are going to have to be his lifeline, but Mutalisks are kind of good, so I don't doubt that he will get back into the game with this fourth base as well. So as long as the Protoss doesn't move out and attack anytime soon, he should win. So, gonna have to see how that plays out.
Well, he is making more stalkers, so unless he is able to split these stalker forces, I don't think Mew's will do any damage. At least he'll do damage, but not much as he wants him to do, because the stalker sounds pretty high. He's also getting blink.
Okay, yeah.
The thing is, though, once those if the mutas can take down the Colossus, those Lings are just going to absolutely destroy the rest of that army.
Pretty much. He does need High Templar, really. Well, Asylum, he has pretty excellent muta control, so I'm not worried. Alejandro, he may be good at blinking, but mutas.
I think those changelings right by the watchtower.
Really?
Yeah.
See, very nice by Asylum. Yeah, if you didn't know, if changelings are near a watchtower, I do believe they can actually control a Zelnaga watchtower.
Yeah.
So, if you have changelings next to a tower, and it has unit, the Protoss player has units there, he may forget that there are four changelings in his army, and he might not realize he doesn't have vision. So, that's a kind of cutesy play by Asylum. I like that. And actually, I don't think... Does Alejandro know about this fourth base? Eh, he does, but he doesn't know the creep is already almost to the Zelnaga Watchtower. So, you know, pretty nice by Asylum. We do see Alejandro taking a fourth base. He needs more minerals to fund his expeditions. But it looks like he's going to go ahead and go on an expedition with four Colossi, a bunch of sentries and immortals and stalkers. Oh my. Now, there are 18 mutalists on the field, almost with plus one. So, 19 stalkers. He may have enough to take this army on directly, but I am unsure as of the moment. But I am sure he is going to lose this third.
He's diving base trade.
Yeah. Yeah, most likely. And here we go. Zerglings going in just to the fourth. Muta's in the main. Why did he recall back? That was a terrible decision. Well, he has a bunch of units at the third just on their own. They're actually doing a lot of damage because Asylum isn't controlling his drones correctly. But here come the Zerglings and the Mutalists and everything good and wholesome about Zerg. And yeah, he's now losing Colossi at his fourth because Colossi, their lasers can't point up, sadly. And that was a very bad choice by Alejandro. He's actually losing most of his army now. And he lost 1, 2, 3, 4 Colossi. Can he get a fifth? No, he's going to run away. But yeah, Asylum just equalized the game right there. Alejandro, if you're listening to this, first off, good luck getting into America from Canada. It's kind of difficult. They increased the border guard by 450 men, I believe, there. But on a second note, never recall when a Zerg is trying to base race you. By that time, they're probably already in your main, snatching up your probes, grabbing your minerals up. You gotta hide your Vespine gas, and hide your gateways too, because they're sniping everything out there.
Hide your wife, hide your kids.
Good, you got the reference I was making. Although I was trying to be discreet about it, but, you know, not too discreet. You know what I'm saying.
Yeah, I know.
But, yeah, I understand. It's okay. We're done. So, Alejandro is fairly far behind now. There are 33 Mutalists on the field with 20 Stalkers. He can actually begin directly engaging the Protoss army now with these,
Because his view counts is so high.
Yeah, and, you know, Mutalists heal, because that's fair.
32 Mutas, actually.
With
31 Mutas.
Yeah, with 6 more on the way, so it'll be 37, and he's on 1, 2, 3, 4 base. He's on 4 base. That's right. He's only mining from 4. You may see one in the top leftish side of the minimap. There's only 4. That one is a false base. It's by a separate hive mine.
Alejandro just warped in 4 zealots at his 4th, but then rallied them to his main army. And then his lings attacked
him there. He had his F2 for selecting all units, and he moved them all over at once.
Pro. Now, these Zerglings may actually get the Nexus if they're microed well. But now, finally, real Zealots came in. Those Zealots that were warped in, they were newbies. They were the weekend warriors, you know. They come every Saturday and Sunday, and they train a little bit. But when they really got into action, they were scared, right? Those weren't real Zealots.
Yeah, they were scared.
But then some official Zealots were called in by the, what do you call the Protoss High Command? Like, what do you call it? It's not the Kala, because that's like their spiritual entity. What do you call it? The council?
I think it's the council.
Alright,
yeah,
well,
the council.
Yeah, that joke's gone and passed now, but what's not gonna pass is 45 mutas letting only 26 stalkers and an Archon take down this third base. So once these mutas come around, they're probably gonna kill the entire Protoss army, because Protoss doesn't have a lot of AA. So if these mutas are spread correctly, he should win in a straight up engagement. But is he gonna go for it? Yeah, he's gonna go for it. Gonna snipe that Archon immediately, and here come the mutas, cleaning up the stalkers. Just, there's so many mutalists. They have plus two attack against only plus one armor, so they're dealing max, pretty, well, not maximum, but a ton of damage, and there go all the stalkers, and the main army for the Protoss player is about to be cleaned up, and good damage done by our Protoss by sniping a base, but a base for your entire army, not exactly a fair trade, so Asylum is again still in the lead here. Mutalists are kind of good units, just a little bit.
Need nerf. I feel
of course.
Right
nerf
now.
Everything but Terran, in my opinion.
Yes.
Are you agreeing with me just to get on my good side?
Yes.
That's okay with me.
Yeah, nerf Asylum, that works good.
I don't think Blizzard has it within their power to nerf Asylum. Please forgive me, David Kim, I didn't mean that. But we do see the Zerg player going into the third base of our Protoss. He tried to kill her earlier, but he's back for more, and I think he's going to get it this time. A couple Stalkers were warped in, but they immediately went down. Probes trying to fight Zerglings. Good luck with that. And there goes the third base. Alejandro, the game's over. That's GG. Alejandro played a good game, but Mutalisks. It was really more of that mass recall back into his main base that cost him. Yeah. He's like, oh, the Zerg's trying to base race me, I better go home and defend. Like I should against Terran and other races. No, you don't. You base race. That is how this matchup is played.
I'm pretty sure he could have won the game if he would have base traded.
Yeah, he had a much better chance of winning the game if he base traded, but yeah, you win some, you lose some. And
before we start the next game.
Yeah, you got time. It's a Team 2 Pro Clan War. You got at least 10 minutes in between every game. Isn't that right, Senex?
Yeah, about that.
Thank you for the music, Senex. Excellent choice, Senex. Excellent choice. Bigger than life. C4, we the business. Man, fuck y'all niggas. Get down the lay down. Shoot up anything except a school or a playground. Triple OG, nigga, these hoes know me. Shiny AK blood, just like the trophy. I'm old school, and I smack a bitch. Getting money like a motherfucking cracker, bitch. What you know about it? Take notes, nigga. YMCMB head coach, nigga. Yeah. Stunt man. Street sweeper in my...
Diamonds all in my brain, nigga. Gold watches, gold chain, nigga. 100,000 champagne, nigga. Yeah, my money insane, nigga. Yeah, I'm making it rain, nigga. But I was just on a plane, nigga. Buying gear, flying here. Fuck what you heard, it's my time of year.
Oh, and special announcement, now that you're back, Rampy, and the music is a little bit lowered. Yeah, I turned it down a little bit. You guys didn't notice it, but we did. Trust me on this. And I would like to welcome to Team 2 Pro, Fantasy. And this is, he's actually SK Telecom Fantasy. He defected to Team 2 Pro to join our rising glory. He obviously doesn't just share the same name. This is actually SK Telecom Fantasy. Isn't that right, Cynics? Yeah, he speaks amazing English. I shouldn't have thought less of Fantasy, but now I'm sure he's actually another robot sent from the future, such as Komodo, Buster Como, excuse me. I sometimes call him Komodo because that's what he looks like, but such as Buster Como or Innovation or Flash, we have yet another robot to add to Team 2 Pro. Add that to the archive.